Hi, everybody, it's Sunday. The world is going crazy. Time to take a break. It's our day to play. It's Sunday, yeah. It's Sunday, whoa. It's Sunday, it's Sunday. Mr. Rogers back
very
there.
Very harpy, harpy.
Sound like I'm, Mr. Rogers.
I'm harping. What does that mean, anyway, if you're harping?
Harping?
Is that complaining?
Oh, yeah, that means like you're yelling. Like a harpy is somebody that yells. Yeah. Well, that fits you. Hi, everybody.
Is that harpy enough for you?
Lorenzo and Tammy are here already.
Lorenzo, Diane,
Dave Zableski's here.
Dave, the big guy.
Susan over in California is here. And Joe, that means Aurelia's here, right, Joe? And your sister Rita, maybe even Tom and Susie Matzik. Hey, how's like the poppy seed, Susie?
That was something, Tom showing up for the show last week.
I delivered poppy seed to Susie yesterday.
Uh-oh. She's in a sugar fit mode.
Oh, yeah. Myrna Larry.
Yeah, she's
here.
Like, no, man.
Hey, you guys, guess what? This is our 50th show, everybody.
Oh,
cheers. Cheers, everybody.
Almost.
50 shows.
It's almost as old as me.
I can't even believe it. It's crazy. I would have never thought in 1,000 years that we would be doing this for 50. Cheers. I got to have a slug here.
A couple of those weeks were...
50's a special number to me. I was just talking to my grandson, Cameron, today, who is 14. I can't believe how old he looks.
He's a numerologist.
He is. And I said, hey, you know what I did, Cameron, is when I turned 50, I decided instead of getting a year older every year, I was going to get one day younger. So actually, I am now 49 and 346 days old. I will be this year. And he goes, no, Grandma, you cannot turn back time. But you know what? You can stop time. So actually,
yeah,
you
right.
could stay 50 for your whole life. I said, I'll take that. That was good. That's a good, I'll take it. 50. Why not? What? Well, hey, what?
She's a stop timeologist.
That's right. Or a Elvira.
A tempologist. All right. We got
my kids all know that formula of my age. I've been saying it for 18 years now. Yes, that I'm 50 years, one day younger every year. Okay, we're going to start. We got some good requests here. Elvira and Earl are here.
And the Earl.
The Earl of Jacot.
And we got our dog here.
Marley is here watching.
He does not like climbing these or going up or down these stairs here. But he's going to like the show today, Marley. There's a lot of dog songs.
Yeah, he's over here waiting for a treat. We're going to start out with an Eagles song that my big brother, Dickie, he's the elder of the family. He is, right, Dickie? He's the oldest. There are seven of us kids in the family.
And he's the funniest of all of you.
He's
got a dry humor.
You know what? Every one of
Dick,
my brothers
I'm sorry
and sisters.
To see what happened to Wisconsin and Illinois today. However, I was happy that because, you know, I like Loyola.
Every one of our family is funny. I love them. Oh, Deacon Marty. Cool. Like, hey, what's a Sunday without Deacon Marty? Hey, good
that's
to see you.
The
most relatable deacon ever. Hey, I know you guys all love the Eagles. Dickie requested this, so here we go with our first song of our 50th show by the Eagles. Oh, we're kind of going in easy.
Every night I'm lying in bed, holding you close in my dreams, thinking about all things that we said coming apart at the seams. We try to talk it over, but the words come out too rough. I know you try to give me the best of your love. Beautiful faces in loud empty places, look at the way that we live, wasting our time on cheap talking wine. Left that so little to give. That same old crowd was like a cold dark cloud that we could never rise above. But here in my heart, I'll give you the best of my love. Oh, oh, sweet darling, get the best of my love. Oh, 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 sweet darling, get the best of my love.
Get the best of my love.
I'm going back in time, and it's a sweet dream. It was a quiet night, and I would be all right if I could go on sleeping. But every morning I wake up and worry, what's gonna happen today? You see it your way, and I see it mine, but we both see it slipping away. You know we always had each other, baby. Oh, I guess that wasn't enough. Oh, oh. But here in my heart, I'll give you the best of my love. Oh, 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 sweet darling, get the best of my love. Get the best of my love. Oh, sweet darling, the best of my love.
Those Eagles are
starting
great.
A kind of easy going on this second day of spring. Technically, I have my spring yellow outfit I found in the back of my closet. How about that? Hey, they like that one. Dave liked the Eagles. That's good. That's good. And it's the 21st of March here. Hey, we had a great time down in Aurelia's house down in Chicago last week. Right, Dominic?
Oh, God.
That was so fun. We were there for a whole week, really.
There was some cooking, serious cooking.
There was a lot. But I actually came back and I hadn't gained any weight. How does that happen? I don't know.
I don't know. You cut part of your body off?
Part of your body?
No, you cut part of your body off.
Oh.
You ever heard of that? You know how to get rid of 20 pounds of ugly fat? Cut off your head.
No, but I know how to get rid of 220 pounds of ugly fat.
What, a divorce?
Kill your husband.
Is that where you're going with that?
That's an old
hilarious
joke. But I made you thin.
Oh, yeah. You made me thin about it?
I did. I made you thin about it. That's like a Desi Arnaz.
That's right. Lucy!
Okay, Lorenzo and Angie, who were actually there in person. Oh, hi there. Hey, Nesta. Good to see you. Nesta and Alan are here. And Colorado's here, Mary and Lana Glass. Hi, Lana. You say Lana, I say Lana. Lana, Luna. Hey,
how
Diane.
How about Vanna? You say Vanna or hey. Vanna? It's important to know.
Different people say that differently, too. Hey, we got a Jimmy Buffett song. I think try and play. The only thing is if I have to do any...
This is Angie's favorite.
Angie and Lorenzo, both of them like this.
Well, Angie especially likes... What's this guy? Jimmy Buffet.
Jimmy Buffet. No, you like the buffets.
Right?
You do. Oh, we both do. Let's admit it. We like it. I like it because it can always choose the low-carb items.
Favorite buffet of all time, the Venetian in Vegas.
Oh, that is good. So this was actually written, or at least, I don't know if it was written by him, but Sam Cooke had a hit on it. As well as Jimmy Buffett, so here we go.
Sam Cooke wrote this before he became a chef.
I'm shaking the egg.
got some money cause I just got paid. How I wish I had someone to talk to. I'm in an awful way. I got in town a month ago. I've seen a lot of guys since then. If I could meet them, I could get them. But as yet I haven't met them. That's why I'm in the shape I'm in. Oh, another Saturday night, and I ain't got nobody. I got some money cause I just got paid. How I wish I had someone to talk to. I'm in an awful way. Another girl, she told me she had a brother who looked just fine. Instead of being my deliverance, he had a strange resemblance to a cat named Frankenstein. Another Saturday night, and I ain't got nobody. I got some money cause I just got paid. How I wish I had someone to talk to. I'm in an awful way. I wish I had someone to talk to. I'm in an awful way. It's hard on a girl when she don't know her way around. I don't find my honey to help me spend this money. I'm heading back to Key West town. Oh, another Saturday night, and I ain't got nobody. I got some money cause I just got. Wish I had someone to talk to. I'm in an awful way. Just another Saturday night, and I ain't got nobody. I got some money cause I just got paid. How I wish I had someone to talk to. I'm in an awful way. Oh yeah.
Yeah, those nights, I remember those nights. Oh, you almost forgot your hat.
I did, kinda.
I remember those Saturday nights.
Oh,
just
yeah,
me, Netflix, and too. Hey, Marley, what you doing? Me and Marley.
Yeah. Yeah, this is...
You almost forgot your...
My whoops. Alan Keller special.
That's right. Al Keller this went in Al his Keller. Closet and found he, a Jimmy Buffett hat.
Yeah. He gave it to me because, of course, he's walked around with this hat for quite a while, and... He's on the lam, so he's got to wear different clothing.
Everybody knew that hat. They knew they'd see him.
Al's using some Nesta's old clothes. Anything. Anything to not get hassled.
Happy hour, 50th show.
Yeah. Speaking of chefs, cooks and chefs, Sam Cook.
Yep.
Al. Was the best. Where
chef
did he,
Supreme.
Where did he cook again? Or chef again?
He used to be at the Golden Rule. Then it became...
Oh, the Golden Rule.
Was it Donaldson's or Dayton's? I can't remember which one it was. Yeah, you Ness will type it up there. But he was up there. Oh, yeah.
He
still
cook.
Is. He's still
he can
great.
Cook up a storm, I'll tell you.
Very
that
nice.
Grits?
Let's see now. We did that. What do we have coming up? Oh, nice. Sue Ottman asked for this one. You know, I'm a big Roberta Flack fan. She was one of the people when I... Some people say, who inspired you? It would have been Roberta Flack back in the day. I was in college back then, loved to listen to her stuff. And you weren't with us when we were in Colorado at the Antlers Plaza. It was early in our career.
I was there with a different band.
Yeah, but not with us. Anyway, this guy came out and did a review of our show. And you know how he described my singing? This is what
the same way they described Mrs. What's her name?
Nope, Miller.
Mrs. Miller?
No. Do you know what?
Something about a garbage can and cockroaches. Or...
No. Mrs. Miller, who was the operatic singer, sang out of tune, for those of you who don't know, it was back in the 60s. Her voice was described as a roach crawling across a trash can.
That, nice.
That's not how he did. He described my singing as a cross between, listen to this, I was like 20 then, maybe 21. Anyway, a cross between... Barbra Streisand.
Singing?
Yes. Oh. Barbra Streisand, okay. Roberta Flack, and the Freckle Face Choir Girl down the road. How about that?
Ah.
I like that. That's good.
That freckle face, baby, you got to say that slow.
Donaldson's. It was Donaldson's.
Donaldson.
But I've always loved her. And I started singing this song. Was one of the very first songs I ever sang when I went out on the road in 1971 is when I first went out on the road to Green Bay, to the Beaumont Inn. I think it was in Green Bay.
That was
downtown. That was my first job. My first job with the Donnie Sanders Show at the time. I was taking the place of Cherie St. James. So it became Donnie Sanders Show. And then soon to meet Steve Grimm in that same show. So we're going to do this one. It's such a gorgeous song, and it's really a ballad. It's slow, but, you know, I love singing it. And Sue, thank you for asking for this. Here we go. First time ever I saw your face, I thought the sun rose in your and the moon and the stars were the gifts you gave to the dawn. The trembling heart of a captive bird that was there. At my ever I saw
Who wrote that?
Do you know, I had that, but I don't know who did that anymore.
Stevie Wonder.
Oh, my God, I love singing that. I got so into it.
Stevie Wonder.
This is the orchestration that I'm using is different than what I've sang for 30 years. Well, 50 years, okay? Mm-hmm. And I just got so into it, I forgot all about that. That's what it was. But anyway, thank you. Thanks, Jimmy. I love singing that stuff. That is me. That's my favorite stuff to do. You know, things where you can sing from your heart and express and kind of storytell a little bit. That's what I love. Hey, you know,
How about this one?
Wait a minute, Dominic. Before we get in that, I've got to tell this story. I have to tell this story because it has to do with the first time ever I saw your face.
My face?
No, the song.
Oh.
It was Steve and I.
Who's on third?
Steve and I had just gotten married. It was in 1973. We took a job down in Springfield, Illinois, just because to do a favor for this agent. It was a bad job.
Bam.
And the rooms in the hotel were very bad. And we were in this room. It was called the Harness House. Now, what does that tell you? Anyway, so we're down there.
It smelled like, you know,
right.
What?
Some of you guys out there might have performed at it. Okay, now listen to this song. So I'm in there singing. I'm singing. At that time, I didn't say much on stage because Steve did all the talking. Those of you who knew Steve knew that. Anyway, so Steve was talking, and most of the talking. Well, I was doing the first time ever I saw your face, and these two gorgeous girls come in, and the stage was kind of set up so that the tables came literally right up to the stage, so I could step on that table if I wanted to. It was the same level as where my feet were, right? And I was only maybe 2 feet from that table, so there's these faces right below me. Anyway, gorgeous girls, you know, very fit. A blonde came in, and another girl come in. And they're sitting there, and I'm singing Your Face the first time. And they start going, yeah, fucking that's right. Yeah, what are you doing? And they're swearing.
What?
I mean, the worst words. The C word, the F word, the B word. And they were friends talking to each other like that, right? So I get done, and everybody else is quiet. They're talking. So me being like 21 or something, whatever I was, I don't say anything on stage, but I look down at them. I says, oh, my God, you guys were so pretty until you opened your mouths. I said that. I can't believe I said that. Well, and
she couldn't either.
And she looks up at me and she goes, yeah, you were too. She did. So.
And then you said.
No, and then we just went on with the show. The show gets done. Come to find out, the manager comes over and says, will you go over and apologize to her? Please go over and apologize to her. She just got out of federal prison for selling hot guns and forging checks, and she is connected to important people. And I wouldn't say mafia family,
you know.
But anyway, it was. And she's dangerous.
Sure.
She's dangerous. Her grandmother was there, and she said, she's my grandmother, but I always, and she was in a wheelchair. She said, I keep a gun in my
robe.
In my robe, she said. And I said, well, you know, me being, what was I thinking, 21? I go, hey, you know, they shouldn't have been talking like that. I'm dumb, right? So we were there. We had a two-week job there.
So wait, you're having this conversation with a customer, and you're on
this
stage.
This is after the show. After the show. And so come to find out, she was tracking me that night. We were in the hotel that had no air conditioning, and it had screens on the windows. The bass player, Richie Ackerman, who still lives in Colorado, had no screens on his window, nor any air conditioning. The window is open, and he's in there, and he hears this talking in a courtyard in this very nasty hotel. And this woman is going, where is that, you know, bazatch? I'm going to shoot her. And the guy's going, put that gun away. We don't need it. Anyway, I had to have armed guards back and forth in my going to the room. We went up. It was a thing. And then after we left, I saved my life somehow. I did not get killed. And the couple days after we left, she went into a place and literally shot up a whole place and ended up going back in federal prison.
She was pretty bold for just getting released.
She broke somebody's jaw with her thumb.
With her thumb?
He had it in her mouth, put it in the mouth, and she broke his jaw. Anyway, that's my story for the day.
What a story.
Tales of the road.
Stuff.
See? Isn't it fun? Isn't it fun being on?
How did her thumb get in his mouth?
And I had just quit smoking.
Jesus.
I'd quit smoking for a year, but during that time I started again. But then I quit. I haven't smoked for 40 years now, but back then I did. And I kind of enjoyed it, I got to say. Okay, we're on. That was a long story, but don't you think it was worth
it? So you
were
instrumental.
Was that story worth it? Come on, it's funny.
For putting her back in the hooscow.
No, I was gone by that time. Here we go. This is one, and you were ready for this one now, Dom. People love country music. People love country music. And this is a George...
It's my calf roping head.
This is a George Jones song.
And this is also from Al Keller.
Al Keller, Batman.
I'm telling you, I had to get rid of all his clothes.
Batman.
He's on the lam, get it?
I know.
This is all gangster stories today.
Right? They are.
How fine gangster you are, too.
So for those of you who like country music and who love George Jones and maybe
if you like
who
country
love,
music, turn it off.
And maybe who loves Sawyer Brown, because this is fun.
Out of it.
Come on, we're going to do this. This is a blast. Here we are, Dominic Tarullo, back here, singing a little George Jones.
Blah, blah.
Feel tears welling up cold and deep inside, like my heart's starting to break. A slab of loneliness, sharp and painful, I may never shake. You may say I was taking it hard since you wrote me off with a call. Don't you wait until I got the sorrow when I get down and fall. Now the race is on and
here comes pride up the backstretch. Heartache thrown to the inside. My tears are holding back, trying not to fall. My heart's out of a running, true love scraps for another's sake. The race is on, it looks like heartache, and the winner loses all. One day I ventured in love, never once suspecting what the final result would be. I lived in fear, waking up each morning, finding that you're gone from me. There's aching pain in my heart, for today was the one I hated to face. Somebody new came up to win her, and I came out in second place. And all the fate is on, and here comes right up the back stretch. Heartaches are going to the inside. My tears are holding back, trying not to fall. My heart's out of a running, true love scraps for another's sake. The race is on, it looks like heartache, and the winner loses all.
Here we go!
Is on and here comes pride up the back stretch. Heartache going to the inside.
My tears are holding back,
trying not to fall.
My heart's out of the running, true love scratch for another's sake. The race is on and it looks like heartache, and the winner loses all.
The winner loses all.
Okay. Hey, you know, Colleen, this hat, I love this hat, Al, by the way. It is my new calf roping hat. We got calves out here. You know, we got a small property, so when I want to go on a big property and rope cows, big cows, I put my big hat on, and I put this hat on for our little calves here, which are little miniature calves we got walking around in the back. In fact, they won't even let me use a rope on them. I've got to use tweezers, zircon-encrusted tweezers.
What's he
zircon
talking about? What is he even talking about?
I know. You know what? I tell you what, I go out there every morning.
Hey.
I get the shower, then I get out, and I got my terry cloth covered.
I don't know what he's talking about.
For my saddle on my little baby horse. I got a little horse. Little kid.
You guys, 50. I've gone through.
Smaller cowboy hat.
Hold everything.
We had to downsize.
I have gone through 50 shows of this. Come on.
Yeah.
What the heck?
Aren't
Cheers,
you
everybody.
Lucky?
50 shows here.
What are you putting in these drinks?
Damn it.
This is very special wine that, by the way, was given to us by Sophie and Vasily. Thank you very much. We had a great time in Chicago. Got to spend some time with them, too. That could be another, that's another story for the books down there, but we're not going to tell you that one. Anyway, we want to thank you. A lot of people, they actually send us wine, and then we've gotten food sent to us. Oh, my God. What else have we gotten? Oh, we've gotten all sorts of fun things. And we want to thank you so much and appreciate the tips that you guys send and for watching us and all your nice comments. And really, without you people, we would not be doing this. This is all about sharing our music with you because, you know.
And it's you sharing our music with other people.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
That's the good part.
We not only appreciate the tips, but also when you share that with other people, then, you know. Kind of, share, it's like Amway. You share it to somebody. Somebody else shares it. Somebody else shares it. Yes, there we go. And beer, there we go.
Yeah, what are you doing on Sunday at 4? Nothing. That's why we picked this.
Yeah, well, now everything's opening up a little bit. It's spring. Doesn't it feel good? And Dominic and I are, like we said last week, entirely vaccinated. Wow, I got to see Cameron, my grandson, today, like I said. Oh, wow. I mean, it was just feels liberating. It really does. Cheers, everyone.
This is Nesta. Old Panther. You ever watch the Three Stooges? Every time they drink whiskey, it's Old Panther.
Old Panther. Oh, my God. This next song, Nesta. Hey, Michigan is here. Pauline Stebbins, I saw Iowa is here. Iowa is here also. And Sue, got your song in for you.
What Iowa? Who Iowa?
The Sioux. The Sioux. Sue.
The Sioux. Oh, from the Sioux tribe?
Yeah, the Sioux. I did the first time I ever saw your face already for you.
Aren't
you
going
to have to go back in time. Go back in time. Okay, happy vaccination. No kidding. Okay, we're going to do this one. I do a whole Patsy Cline show, and this is one of the songs I do Patsy Cline's version of. And we're going to do this, and Nesta said, please, please. No, she didn't. She said she loves this song, so we're going to do this for you. See if you remember who did this. Originally was the first person to record this. Here we go. The wayward wind is a restless wind. A restless wind that yearns to wander, and he was born the next of kin to the wayward wind in a lonely shack. By the railroad track, he spent his younger days. And I guess the sound of the outward bound made him a slave to his wandering way. And the wayward wind is a restless wind. A restless wind that yearns to wander, and he was born the next of kin, the next of kin to the wayward wind. Oh, I met him down in a border town. He vowed we'd never part. Though he tried his best to settle down, now I'm alone with a broken heart. And the wayward wind is a restless wind. A restless wind that yearns to wander, and he was born
next of kin, the next of kin to the wayward wind, the next of kin to the wayward wind.
Good song. Good song. Nesta, thanks for giving me to that. You're right. It was Gogi Grant, G-O-G-I Grant. Gogi Grant.
What was her first name? What did she short? Why did she shorten Gogi? Gogi from Gogenstein or whatever her first name was.
Maybe it's Georgette or something. Who knows? Is Gogi short for something?
Go-go.
What do you
go-go
think?
Go-go Gogi.
Wait a minute, Rita. Did
she was a Gogi?
Rita said she put one word there. She said painting. Now, were you saying that you're painting, or were you wondering about those paintings back there? Because actually, these two, that way,
and
backwards. They are not. They're his first paintings he did.
They're in the basement for a reason.
No, we got them here because it's our new studio, because we're sick of moving things up and down the stairs. And,
you know, I've taken the drawing and
no,
and
those were his first candies. Classes you took, Dominic. They were Bob Ross classes. And you did a great job. Look at that. I'm grabbing one right now. Okay, we're gonna take it. Woo, woo. Oh.
Look at all the happy little accidents.
Look at that's good,
but
Dominic.
I gotta say,
that was one of his first attempts.
It's a
come
good,
on. It's good.
It's a good thing to
I'm
do.
I'm putting it back over here.
Got
oh my God!
Nothing
I
to do.
I want to tell you something. That wine that those guys gave us is stronger.
I told you it's Old Panther.
It is stronger than what
wine?
We usually do. I'm not kidding you. Here, see what I'm gonna show you. What just fell? You may notice. See back on this thing. Does it look like a chess set? It is a chess set, and a. Yes, it is. And 100 years ago,
I don't play.
A long, many, many years ago, for Steve, for a present, I actually hand painted these. Oh, look at that queen! Isn't she good? Look at her. She's cute. She's the queen. There she is. I painted that because my mom. How many of you had your mom doing ceramics classes and making all sorts of ceramic stuff? Well, mine did too. She taught it, so I went in there with her. But you know what was funny? Is she did the ceramics class, and every night from ceramics class, she'd come home and she'd go, you know that ceramics, I love it so much, because when I come home, I just feel like I got so much energy, I just can't get to sleep, and oh, my mind's just working like everything, and here she was inhaling all that spray plastic, like it was basically inhaling airplane glue.
So she got hooked on the class.
She did. She loved it. And so did everybody else, of course. Hey, Mary, hey, you who says that they weren't any good, Mary Jane Pollock said she loved it.
She loved what?
Your painting.
My painting?
She just said that. She loves it.
Oh, Mary.
Okay.
Mary.
Now, what do we have next here?
You're just being nice.
This is so many words. That wine is getting to me a little bit, I got to tell you. I'm kind of surprised because usually, you know, I'm just slugging
away. Usually what?
I don't feel it. Nice job painting, says Lorenzo. He liked it too. And, okay, we're going to do this. This is a, what am I going to say? Oh, we told him to share. This is something else I want to say is that April 9th. Oh, you know what? I'll save that for later. We'll talk about it. I'm going to get on to some music. This is a Paul Simon song. Here we go. Diane requested this for our 50th show, Diane.
Hey, yeah. Oh, I was going to say something.
What? It's about to start any minute.
It's going to start?
Yes. 50th show for Diane. Oh. See what happens? Because I was doing too many things at once. The problem is all inside your head, you said to me. The answer is easy if you take it logically. I'd like to help you in your struggle to be free. There must be 50 ways to leave your lover.
said, it's really not my habit to intrude. Furthermore, I hope my meaning won't be lost or misconstrued, but I'll repeat myself at the risk of being crude. There must be 50 ways to leave your lover. 50 ways to leave your lover. Sing along now. Just slip out the back chat. Oh, make a new plan, sing. No need to be coy, Roy. Just get yourself free. Hop on the bus, gun. No need to discuss much. Just drop off the key to leave and get yourself free. Oh, slip out the back chat. Make a new plan, stand. No need to be coy, Roy. Just listen to me. Just hop on the bus, Gus. No need to discuss much. Hop on the key to leave and set yourself free. He said, it grieves me so to see you in such pain. I wish there was something I could do to make you smile this way again. I said, I appreciate that. And would you please explain about the 50 ways? He said, why don't we both just sleep on it tonight? And I believe that in the morning, you'll begin to see the light. And then he kissed me and I realized he probably was right. There must be 50 ways to leave your lover. 50 ways to leave your lover. Just slip out the back chat. Make a new plan, stand. Don't need to be coy, Roy. Set yourself free. Oh, hop on bus, Gus. Don't need to discuss much. Drop off key to leave and set yourself free. Slip out the back chat. Make a new plan, stand. No need to be coy, Roy. Just listen to me. Oh, hop on the bus, Gus. No need to discuss much. Hop on the Geely and get yourself free.
Whoops, almost went into the next song. Okay, it did go in the next song. That was fun, wasn't it?
Oh, yeah.
All right. Hey, I like that one. That's a lot of words. Fast.
A lot of words
very fast.
Very quick.
What I was saying was about the Sheldon. I talked about it before, but now it's actually coming to be. They are going to be live streaming from the beautiful Sheldon Theater. I'll be putting some pictures of it on Facebook. And it's called the Girl Singers Show of Shows.
Starring Sid Caesar and Imogene Coca.
Starring Debbie O'Keefe, Katie Garrity, me. You're going to be on it, and Reed is going to be playing drums, and Norton Llewellyn.
Rita's going to be on
Reed.
It. Oh, Reed.
Reed Grimm.
Oh, yeah. Well,
and then also, we're going to be doing songs from Girl Singers of the Hit Parade, all the songs from the 50s, songstresses, part of the Sirens of the 60s, and then also from our Belting Babes of Broadway, a little bit of each one. And it's going to be streamed. It's only $10 they're only charging. Do you believe that, Dominic?
God.
$10?
Well,
I mean,
what
it's on a Friday night.
Bucks? You can't stand night. Still in one place and not get charged $10.
I know. It is on
like
a...
Like this.
Right?
Somebody's going to hand you a bill.
It's on a Friday night. And that same Friday night, I was supposed to have been singing there with a 60-piece symphony and chorus, a 40-voice chorus with my... Cinema at the Symphony show.
Yeah.
All movie themes, but of course they've all been canceled. I can't wait to get back to that.
Well, you know, sometimes those things have musicologists. You know, you've been talking about different ologists here. Yes, you have. Unwittingly, you've been talking. And I am going to tell you that we have a windologist, which is our favorite. Lovely.
I can't say favorite.
Lovely. One of our favorite lovely people, Diane.
One of our favorite.
Diane. In White Bear.
She happened to
White
notice.
White Bear Diane.
She happened to notice the wind out there. It is super windy here today.
It did. It was super windy.
It is bad.
Well, you know, it was so bad, Colleen, that this morning I went out there to get the paper, even though we don't get the paper.
What happened, Dominic?
I was chasing the dog out there, but
right?
I opened the door, and
yeah?
I got hit in the face with a toupee.
No!
Honest to God.
No. Yeah. Not a toupee.
She wanted to hear that.
She did. She loves it. So
she's
did Roger.
Lovely.
Roger,
I love her.
Roger wanted to hear that too.
What? What? She's a windologist.
Don't
she is a windologist. And who asked for that wayward wind?
That would have been Susie.
That's a
I mean, that would have not Sue, but Nesta.
Nesta is a windologist.
Right. There, people are commenting about our
what?
Spiral staircase.
Oh yeah, you're gonna go up
yes.
and down like
no, Loretta I'm just
Young.
Posing on.
Don't
it.
Fall down there.
I'm just posing.
That's
on
a funny one.
Yeah, I love this. We had you know there were this of course the stairs was not here all the time, but you couldn't get down here and. As our family grew, we needed to have a stairway to get
there
down.
There used to be an elevator, but they had it removed and put the stairs.
I love this. People remember this about our house here. All right, here we go. Okay, we're on the next one. Dominic, this is one of yours.
Both of these hands.
For this one, really?
She's
for your solo?
Al Keller. Who's the best?
Very nice.
What a chef.
You want to use your keep your hat on for this
I'm
one?
I'm going to leave it
it's
on
because
it's
a Motown.
I think it goes with the tune.
This is Motown. This goes with Motown?
Motown. Yeah.
This is.
Motown,
it?
Larry what? Town, Curly Town. What's the difference?
Wouldn't you say this is a Motown song? Dominic?
This was a Three Stooges
We used
special.
To do this one in the Trade Winds, too. So here we go.
What key is this?
Thing? Oh, yeah.
Oh,
Sue
yeah.
is finally getting to see Ricky Nelson's kids at Treasure Island. That's going to be fun.
You know, I'm going to wait till Ricky Ricardo's kids are there because that'll be even more fun. Lucy!
No, that's, there's,
Ricky
they got a couple
Ricardo.
Daughters.
I was
right?
watching them the other day. They had the long trailer on.
Dino, Desi, and Billy. Maybe they're out there.
What was the name of that tune?
Dino, Desi, and Billy?
Oh, they had a big hit.
What was it? I don't know.
Dino,
Desi, and Billy, remember that?
They had a great song.
Yeah, it was a good song.
It was a monkey-ish song.
Was it, Everybody Loves a Clown?
No. That's scary.
Was it? What was it?
No, it's kind of a good one. I think it must be Boston
okay.
Heart. Here goes Lorenzo. Quick.
Quick,
somebody
has.
Come on. Let's go.
He says, you got some splaining to do.
Splaining?
Okay, here we go, Dom. Here's your Motown.
Oh, wait.
Here we are. Woo!
I don't want to lose. Oh, this good thing that I got. If I do, I will surely lose a lot.
Don't call me Shirley.
Cause her love is better than any love I know.
Ready? Here we go.
It's like thunder, lightning. The way you love me is frightening. You got better knock on wood, baby. I'm not superstitious about you, but I can't take no chance. You got me spinning, baby. Cause your love is better than any love I know. It's like thunder, lightning. The way you love me is frightening. I better not. I'm worried, baby. It's no secret that woman fills my loving cup. Cause she sees to it that I get enough. Just one touch from her, you know it takes so much. It's like thunder. Lightning,
That was a Wilson thing.
The way you love me is frightening. I better knock on wood, baby. Oh yeah, I think I better knock, knock, knock on wood. Think I better knock, knock, knock on wood. Think I better knock, knock, knock on wood.
Boy, that took me way back with the Fabulous Rogues. Me and the Gaudio Brothers and Pat and Fazito.
Oh, wait, the Rogues, the Fabulous Rogues.
And the Fabulous Nikki LaCoco.
I was with the Fabulous Trade Winds with the Fabulous Nate Landrum. Doing the same thing, probably the same time.
Doing Knock on Wood?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, Nikki.
Oh, yeah, definitely. Have a big
smoke
one.
This one.
We did
Knock on Wood for at least a half hour.
No, we didn't. No.
It was a jammer.
No, we did not.
Change the key.
Tammy is...
let me sing it.
Tammy is with us. Tammy Craven. Tammy and Jerry.
Tammy,
Jerry's retiring
Craven.
Pretty soon. And let's see what's next to say. Oh, I missed it.
Jerry, have you retired yet?
Hi, Nancy Keys is here.
Get out of there. Before the weather gets bad. Good.
Right?
Retire.
What? Retire what?
Jerry.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I was reading something. I'll see. That's what happens.
We're going to play golf with them.
Okay, we have a song here now. Tammy actually asked for a song about it, which I hope to get to it sometime. Tammy Craven asked for, what was the name of that song that I couldn't do?
That you couldn't do?
Because we didn't have time to
put it in. The
auctioneer?
Hey,
no, we can't do that one either. It was the Leon Rimes song.
Leon Rimes. Leon Rimes.
Can't live. No, it's.
Rhyming Leon?
How can I live without you? But I really didn't know that song. We just didn't have time to put it in because we were traveling from wherever to wherever. But I thought, Tammy, I thought this song, which I really already knew, and I've never sung it, had this kind of the same thought to it. So I thought we'd pop this in for you this week, Tammy.
A substitute.
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 A substitute.
As
that's right.
The Who would say a substitute.
Right. Lorenzo was saying you guys, the Rogues, used to practice in the garage.
Oh,
so
yeah.
You were literally a garage band.
We were when we were in the garage, and then if we were at Rush Up, we weren't.
Well, hey,
we're falling off that two-story stage.
Our singer did. Oh, we all had our falling off stage moments.
Yeah, but that was a high one. and more than that was high.
So we're going to do this song. It's a Nilsson song for you right now. Here you go, Tammy. I hope you guys like this because... You know, not only Nilsson wrote it, but there a lot of people recorded this. They did. I'm forgetting who, but I know that Mariah Carey did. And, oh, my God, there was,
Soupy
I think,
Sales.
Maybe I think Karen Carpenter even
Soupy
did it.
Did it.
I don't know, but anyway, here we go, a Nilsson song.
No, I can't forget this evening or your face when you were leaving. But I guess that's just the way the story goes. You always smile, but in your eyes your sorrow shows. Yes, it shows. No, I can't forget tomorrow when I think of all my sorrow. When I had you there, but then I let you go. And now it's only fair that I should let you know what you should know. I can't live if living is without you. I can't live. I can't live anymore. I can't live. Living is without you. I can't give. can give anymore. When I can't forget this evening, your faces I were leaving, but I guess that's just the way the story goes. You always smile, but in your eyes your sorrow shows. Yes, it shows. I can't give anymore, can't live. If living is without you, I can't live. I can't give anymore. No. Oh, I can't live. I can't.
I love that song too.
You were going to do a medley there, weren't you?
I was. Almost. Hey, thank you. Hey, you know, the Malins are here. Very inspirational Aww. People. Thank you. Not only
Their
do they.
Their kids are too.
Not only do they send us all the props and things we need, but they send us props. That means props.
Stage properties.
No, props.
Properties.
What does that mean? Props.
Props.
When people give you props, they give props. You. What does that say? Propitiation? What is that? What does props stand for? When people give you props, they give
props.
You
properties,
like
stage
compliments,
properties.
But also very inspirational. You guys love the Malins and also their children, Walter Malin and
Marsha Malin.
There we go. Hey, that Jean Whoa. Johnson. Thank you. She liked that one too. I love singing that, Tammy. Thank you. Now I was. We got to always
a substitute.
We get so many requests for Beatles songs. I can't stand it. This one, I'll tell you what it is because you already heard the beginning notes. It was A Hard Day's Night. Dominic, off the top of your head now, what year do you think A Hard Day's Night came out?
1963.
1964.
Okay, I got
very
to look
close,
at it.
Very close. Because I was in middle school then, what you call middle school.
Yeah. The one with the short bus you were on.
Going to the roller rink. And we would roller skate to all these songs. Oh, my God. All the guys from the neighboring town, Spring Valley, River Falls, Bay City.
All the cool guys?
Right. Yeah.
Who had the coolest guys? Uh-oh, are we disconnected?
No. I thought I turned the internet off. It is off. How can Siri be talking to me when the internet's off? That's what I want to know.
It's trying
They're
to
listening
answer
at all
one
times.
Of your goofy questions.
Okay, could be. So, right. Yeah, we did that. It was so much fun. You know when they did that movie, A Hard Day's Night?
Yeah.
Do you know what the whole budget was for the whole movie?
$20.
$245,000 for the entire movie. That is
well,
like nothing.
Movie. That's
Beatlemania, nice. People. Beatlemania.
They were just
here
running
we go.
All over the place. Remember, they were running here and running there and running here. That's all, because the girls wanted to watch them run for some reason.
He's saying,
look at the Olympics.
Lorenzo is saying that Siri is scary. Siri is scary. So is Alexa. I think Alexa is scarier than Siri.
Really?
Yep. There she showed
scary.
Up again. You no
Siri.
Good Siri. I do not even have the
it
internet
said,
on
I'm
that.
Not scary.
It's on my iPad. They're going through. They don't need the internet anymore. Oh, my God. It's singularity. It's happening now. It's everywhere.
Singularity?
It's hearing us through everything. Okay. Anyway, here we go. Let's all go back and get all those memories of Beatlemania, people. Here we go.
It's a good chord.
It's been a hard day's night, and I've been working like a dog. It's been a hard day's night. I should be sleeping like a log. But when I get home to you, I find the things that you do will make me feel all right. You know I work all day to get your money to buy a thing, and it's worth it just to hear you say you're gonna give me everything. So why on earth should I moan? 'Cause when I get you alone, you know I feel all right. When I'm home, everything seems to be right. When I'm home, feeling you holding me tight, tight, yeah. It's been a hard day's night, and I've been working like a dog. It's been a hard day's night, I should be sleeping like a log. But when I get home to you, I find the things that you do will make me feel alright. So why on earth should I moan? 'Cause when I get you alone, you know I feel okay. When I'm home, everything seems to be right. When I'm home, feeling all to be tight, tight, yeah. It's been a hard day's night, and I've been working like a dog. It's been a hard day's night, I should be sleeping like a log. But when I get home to you, I find the things that you do that make me feel alright. You know I feel alright, yeah. You know I feel alright.
There. Oh. And here we are, another. And thank you. Thank you, folks, for all watching. Once again, thank you for all your comments. We appreciate you, you know, chiming in there and saying stuff. That adds to the show a lot. You know that, don't you? And thank you for the wine and the food and the tips and for watching and the good spirits. And
for sharing.
And for sharing, sharing to everybody else. We appreciate that.
Is that what you call that?
That's right.
Sharing on Facebook.
Sharing on Facebook or wherever. And then I also put it on YouTube. So if you want to watch it anytime, just go to Colleen Raye YouTube. And it's there. All my shows are on there if you want to review them from day one, 50, all 50 shows. Pretty much all 50 shows are on YouTube if you want to see them. So we love you. Keep the requests coming. That's really important, too. That's how we figure this out, all your requests. And if we don't get to your requests, don't feel bad because we got, I have to put a show together, paste it right. It's complicated. Plus, I only have so much time. So there we go. Lots going on. Cheers, everyone. We will see you next week, show 51, and then it's our year anniversary after that. Cheers, everyone. See you next week. The world is going crazy. Time to take a break. It's our favorite day because of you. It's Sunday, yeah. It's Sunday, whoa, it's Sunday. See you next Sunday. We love you guys so much. You're the best, and I'm not kidding. I mean it.
See you, ma'am.